pizza, but, you know, we're all sitting here with this pit in our stomach because we don't know what the heck you're going to do. And a lot of times, y'all don't do the right thing. We're here to support who we think should be mayor. I also think we should eventually actually vote on our mayor, so this process of the pit in the stomach will never have to happen. We vote on a mayor that represents us for 4 years. We don't do this funny shuffling. There's always an issue when it comes to this funny shuffling. But tonight, I want to encourage all of the councilmen to do the right thing. It's Teresa's turn. Thank you.
Good evening, Dottla Ponizil. Congratulations, Kristen. Well fought, battle, and I'm proud of anyone who is civic service-minded enough to go through this and do this job. This is a really hard job. And welcome back, Teresa. I'm totally thrilled. This was by accident.
Yeah.
Just, well, sure, I just had this, you know, I have a couple. Judy said to make it short and sweet. Okay, when I was in kindergarten, there was this little merry-go-round. I was born in Czechoslovakia, right? And there was this little merry-go-round thing that they had with little chairs, and it was just a magical thing for me. And I remember this one day, I was waiting in line to get a turn because, you know, there were only so many seats, like five, and there were 20 kids or something, and so you had to wait to get on. And this one day, I'll never forget this. They skipped me or something, and I didn't get my turn in the merry-go-round. And I really think this process is that simple. You take your turn, and there's no votes. There's no who's better or worse. You just take your turn, and you don't worry about it. And I hope you guys will be smarter than the people in that kindergarten class or the teacher
to,
that didn't.
First of all, encourage let you me have to a make turn. Teresa the next mayor. And actually, rather than say much, I was going to let you do the speaking, and I was going to play back the tape from last year, a year ago, same vote. There was a lot of talk. I think I picked a clip. I think, Jim, you said it best. I think I'll just let you say it again.
Good idea. I don't think it's going to disrupt anything here at the end of next year.
Just a sec.
Pick up from here. We'll go down there. You jump back in front of me. This is an extraordinary circumstance. I think it's only fair, and I think this council, I think as colleagues, I think it's the right thing for us to do, and I'd like to do it, so that's where I'm at.
And Jim?
Yeah, thank you, Madam Mayor, Dan, for that explanation, and I need to make sure I understand the motion. Let me see if I can't paraphrase what I think I heard you say. I think the end result would be that Maggie serve as deputy mayor for 2010, sort of to fill the voids experienced as mayor this year due to her battle with cancer. And that remain in the current normal rotation for mayor. Is that kind of what you're painting right here?
Well, you know, any of those things are always decided by the council, but my view would be the two of us would go down there and Maggie would jump back in front of me. I don't know. That's sort of what I've got in mind.
I'm just trying to make sure that we're not putting something together here that purposely drops out Teresa, but by the same token, keeps moving this thing forward. I do feel the same compassion that you described for Maggie to struggle through her cancer in the year. She missed a lot of opportunities, maybe filling those voids with the deputy mayor in 2010. But in 2011, then, once those you moved both you and Maggie down to the far end of the dais, then Teresa would then be in a position for the normal rotation to become the mayor in 2011. Is that correct?
So I think, Jim, you said it very well there. I wanted everybody to hear it. Thank you.
Evening, Mayor and Council, Brad Roth, Cardiff. I just want to reiterate what other people have said. I think it's Teresa's turn to be mayor. I think it would be a big mistake to skip over her. Thank you.
She is our next, and then Dolores Welty and Livia Borak. Okay.
Good evening. I'll make this quick also. Along with those comments, Jim, you also talked about not leaving Teresa Barth out in the cornfield. I remember that because it was one of your folksy comments that, despite everything else, I enjoy. So, all I'm saying to you is I think it's time to vote Teresa Barth out of the cornfield and into the mayorship of the city of Encinitas. She has served her 4 years. You may not have expected her to get reelected, but she did. Big time. And we're here to witness and make sure that she slides one seat to the right, left, and that she becomes mayor of the city for this year. It's kind of a benign act. You know, I don't think she's going to burn the building down or do anything like that. So I think it's her turn and her time. And I'm looking at all three of you and expecting you to do the right thing. Thank you.
Dolores Welty, Lucadia, Sheridan Road. I would like to thank all of you for the work that you do on the council. I have a real tough time sometimes concentrating, and I'm sure you do too, but you come back night after night and do it week after week. I wanted to say thanks to Dan, too, for his service as well, and congratulations to both our returning and our new council person. I, of course, do support Teresa as mayor, do not want to see her skipped over, and I think 4 years apprenticeship is pretty good. So thank you very much.
Livia Borak is our next speaker, followed by Judy Burlfine.
Good afternoon. I'd like to say congratulations to the returning and the new council members. My name is Livia Borak. I live in Encinitas, in Lucadia, and I work in Encinitas. I've lived here for quite a few years now, and I'm really proud to be a resident here. And I'm also looking forward to your first action as a city council and doing the right thing, making good on the promises that were made to the people, and making Teresa the next mayor. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Judy Burlfine. No surprises, I second Jim Bond's statement. I think it'd be great to have Teresa as mayor, and I love what Dodla said. I think, you know, I work so hard to teach my children to play fair, and I look forward to all of you setting a good example for them that I can tell them about. Thank you.